Thank you. Thank you. I must tell you. Thank you. Yeah. Hello.
Oh. Short bit of music from Ms. McCray, where I call Pauline Johnson. Is she here?
No,
she's not here. Okay, so we begin. Let us begin our program.
All our sins and grief to bear. What a privilege to God we love. Everything to God in prayer. Oh, oh, what peace we often fall. Thank you. to my friend, Miss Microsoft.
Let us have a word of prayer. Our God and Father in heaven, Lord, we worship, we praise, and we bless your holy name. Father, you know that we're gathered here this afternoon because you have chosen to call your son Boris home. But the family is here, my God, and they need your comfort. They need you to protect them, O Lord, my God, and give them the strength that they need at this time. So I pray, Father, you will cover them, you will uphold them, and you will give them that peace that passes all understanding, that peace that comes only from you. So bless them, I pray, in Jesus' name. Amen. The first lesson comes from Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verses 1 to 8. Is Kelsey here?
From Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 1 to 8. To everything there is a season and a time for every purpose under the heaven. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to pluck up that which is planted. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to break down and a time to build up. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones together. A time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to get and a time to lose. A time to keep and a time to cast away. A time to rent and a time to sue. A time to eat alone and a time to sleep. A time to love and a time to hate. A time of war and a time of peace.
Lisa?
Where we can come before your presence this afternoon, Father. It is not by my knowledge, it's by power, but we come to you by your spirit, Lord Jesus. And so, Lord, as we come, Lord Jesus, we celebrate the thanksgiving, O God, service, O God, of our dear brother, father, uncle, Lord Jesus, we name them, and we know each and every one right now. Lord Jesus Christ, we give you thanks, Lord, for the time that he spent with us here on earth. Lord, I pray, God, that heaven may receive his soul, Father, hallelujah. Oh God, as you know, God, as we come, Lord Jesus, we pray that you comfort us, Lord. In a time like this, Lord Jesus, we need your comfort, Heavenly Father. And so, God, we can't do it on earth by ourselves, Lord. And so we are depending on you right now, mighty God. Oh God, to comfort the family, Father God, in a very special way. Oh God, we give you thanks, Lord Jesus, because to be absent in the body, oh God, is to be present with you, Father. And so, Father God, it is our duty this afternoon to worship you and to give you glory and to praise you, God. You said in everything, Father God, we must give you thanks. And so, God, we give you thanks right now, Heavenly Father. Oh, God, we pray that you be with each and every one right now. Everything, Lord Jesus, that to be said and everything that to be done. Lord, I pray that you will be glorified, God, at the end of this service, Father. We look to you, we give you praise. We give you glory, we honor you right now, God, and we look to you. And we rest everything in your care right now. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, my sister. Dexter? Okay, Jeffrey Walker.
We go ahead
Okay, so you have a medley of songs?
Yes.
Okay.
Guys, stand up. This is one record like music.
Let's stand up.
Dancing.
Hallelujah. Come on, let's celebrate this life. We're not a circle. We are broken.
Got my back. Michelle, he will be like, Michelle, don't be surprised. Michelle alone is going on one cheek on that. On the other hand, it would be like he said to his girlfriend, yeah, if you prove say love me, I'm gonna keep your body the kind of set up. And then I'm sick then. Maybe I can't thank you enough. You struggle all the way from the resort. When everybody on the busy schedule has to work, you was there. Even the hospital, doctors and nurses, they would hire you. They see your love. I appreciate it and I will never forget. And he felt it like if somebody is taking care of him, you know, he would do whatever. But when he sees Nelly for some reason, in the last part, he had a speech delay. So, you know, sometimes you have to go to understand what he said, but maybe not everything. Michelle, the only time Michelle hear what he said is when you want to pee. She likes to take you privately. He wanted water and he asked for water and she wanted to pee with the pee and stuff. He was like, idiot. But I can tell you, he was a lovely man. He put everything for his children.
Let's study into our world.
You know what perfect most? My dad worked all his life and he never get a chance to go on vacation. He don't do nothing, no party, don't do none of that. Because all he care about is taking care of his children, even his grown kids. That's very sad. And I just think that I'm still dreaming, like I'm here. And that is in a cat. How is that possible? How is that possible? So I wanted to take a trip to my dad. He's here. We're going to get a chance to. I could have buried him here. He don't like cold at all. He don't like cold at all. And he said he want to be creative. He don't want to be here in America. He just wanted, you know, to bring money and go back home. He loved Jamaica. You know, God said he give it and he take it. But I could tell you if I could say come back then. If it's even one word said. But it's six then. The way he loved one, he was telling me that he just want to get picked up. Some of them come with a poor woman, see if somebody gets it from them. That's not him, he's not with a woman. And he, you know, he was like, I'm asking God to give me a second chance, because if I get a second chance, I would turn my life around. I would not give 100, but I was still give 70. He did, I was just hoping he would get one more chance. But then, I'll see you in heaven one day.
Thank you. Our second scripture reading comes from the book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 15, verses 57 to 58.
Afternoon, everyone.
Afternoon.
Afternoon. Beloved, we shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed. In a moment, in the twinkle of an eye, at last, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. But this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortal. So this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality. Then shall be brought to pass, saying that it is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brother, be steadfast, unmovable, always abundant in the work of the Lord, for as much as we know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. I'm going to ask Louise to come at this time and read the obituary.
Good afternoon, family, friends, and loved ones. Thank you for coming to share the joy and the life of our dear brother, Maurice Thompson. Maurice Thompson, affectionately called Rocky, was born on July 12, 1966, to the late Alva and Sigismund Thompson, otherwise called Alva and Sikia. At Mount Olive District in the parish of St. Catherine, where he was born and raised. He attended Gingery Orleans School. He's the ninth child of the couple's 14 children and the sixth son of seven. Rocky also had eight half siblings, sisters and brothers that we shared by our father's side. He has left a total of 19 sisters and brothers to mourn his loss. As a child growing up in Jamaica, Rocky was full of life, adventurous and unique. He was a kid who would climb up on the kitchen counter and have all the iron pots rolling down the gully, wet like a chicken. On one occasion, I remember he was about 35 years old. He had on a blue braces short and a white shirt. And when he climbed up on the pata, everybody who come from Jamaica, he made it about pata. And then the water fell from the pot. The pot was rolling down the hill and he was wet. He ran and he said, "We're wet like a chicken. We're wet like a chicken." My mom said to this neighbor's son, "Where go catch him for me?" Rocky said, "Where, Mr. Larkin beat you for me? Where, Mr. Larkin beat you for me?" So we grew up teasing him, "The wet like a chicken. Where, Mr. Larkin beat you for me?" Anybody remember that? He was the kid who would pick up lizards and frogs and run after the rest of us with his friends. He was that schoolboy who ran out of class when teacher dared to hit him with the belt and would return the next day. Of course, after mama had to go to school, he would return the next day with his nicest fear and the prettiest, biggest man of the teacher. The same teacher who he ran away from the day before. No wonder why at the age of 16 years old, to prevent him from getting into trouble, my older sister Lynette, God bless her soul, is sitting right over there. She took him to live with her in Kingston. And she set him up with a shoemaker where he learned the art of shoemaking. Rocky was the best local parts maker in Canada, because at school, during school time, every child gets out in their class going back to school. Whether their parents would pay off the money or all of the money, they would go wear in class Baptist school, our shoes that my brother knew. He was a hard worker. And when he was not doing shoemaking, or because the business was slow, he would farm all kinds of crops and buy and sell all kinds of goods, including tambourine, to support every single one of his seven children. Yes, Rocky was highly favored by God, and with his seven children, his oldest, Francine, filed for him 4 years ago because she wanted the best for him to live here with her in America. But as she mentioned earlier, his dreams was to go back home. As a matter of fact, he told many of my siblings back home in Jamaica that he was coming back in. Yes, he's going back in. Right? He passed away in April. The oldest child, Francine, followed by Rakisha, Jamelia, and his youngest daughter, Cece, and sons Rico, Jarul, and Maurice Jr. These children all blessed him, all the ones that are of childbearing age, blessed him with 11 grandchildren. Like King David and King Solomon, my brother Rocky loved women. And so some of them were at his bedside at the time in his last few days, taking care of him. Michelle and Jackie, thank you for also being there in his last moments. Karen, thank you for the kids that you have given him, and we will share and take care of them. My brother would ask you were here. As his daughter mentioned, even his adult children, he never tells them no. Some of them use them. Every week they would send someone here, he's not telling them no. But that's Rocky. Rocky not only took care of his children, Rocky took care of his neighbor's children. What God would ask of any one of us on that great day, Bishop? Will he have so many houses be left behind? Or how many money be left in the bank? How many land or cars? No. He's gonna ask, when I was hungry, did you feed me? When I was naked, did you clothe me? When I was homeless, did you give me a place to sleep? People will remember you, not for the material things you leave behind. It is the legacy that Rocky has left behind that people will remember him for. The true meaning of love, unselfishness, kindness, the life he taught. One of my sisters told me that her lucrative business declined due to her illness. Her money in the bank was depleted due to Dr. Bill. She had no money, no feed to feed her sick self and her two children. She was sitting at home with her hands on her jaw, wondering what was next. When she looked in the distance and she saw someone coming with two bags, hardly carried two bags. As the person approached, she realized it was Rocky. Not only did Rocky bring food for her, he left her money. And Rocky would pop in periodically to ensure that the limit and her children were fed. That's the brother. He's gone. Another sister said, she felt in a hard time. She was 9 months pregnant, and her boyfriend, her children's father, had run into the law because he was being there. She had nothing. My brother heard. And he sent a message to her to send her daughter for food and money. And every Friday, she said, until her boyfriend got out of jail, Rocky provided food for her and her children. Rocky's community in Central Village is saddened by his loss. According to my niece and my sister there, young men that passed by said that when Rocky was around, they were never hungry. They get lunch money and they get bus fare for school. Rock his nieces and nephews said in an unapologetic way that Uncle Rockley was the best uncle. The way he treats them. Rocky was the son that looks out for his parents, the elderly neighbor, the young child. One of my sisters told me that when mama gets off the bus coming from market, Rocky is that child who would take several trips up the hill and hurry to come back to meet mama to take her last bath, just to make sure that mama did not even know to carry. Rocky was intolerant of hypocrisy. He called a spade, vexed with him or not, he didn't care. But he did not hold on to grudge or malice. Rocky has led us all to mourn. But the Rocky I remember would stand this up on a cry, on our cry. Man, you like to man cry, no, sure. So cry you must. Because we've been endured for a night, but joy comes in the morning. So, all of Rocky's seven children, I ask of you, every single one of you, to look out for each other, love each other, dare not your different mothers. You come from different mothers. You are the same father's blood. Look out for your one another. Have each other's back. Take care of baby Cece. She's 8 years old. That's what Rocky would have wanted from every one of you are listening over the Zoom today. Leaven up his legacy of love, kindness, and unselfishness being there. Sleep on, Rocky. Sleep and take your rest. Lay down your head upon your Savior's breast. We love you well, but Jesus loves you best. Good night.
Thank you very, very, very much. I'd just like to make a statement. This is funeral number 188 I'm doing since pandemic started last year in one room. And the thing that stands out is when a person could be dealing with so many people, the one thing everybody has to say is about the fact that he is selfless, he loves, he cares. I get the impression that he's the kind of person who would take his shirt off of his back.
Yeah.
Just heed what was just said. Do what he would have wanted you to do when it came to loving each other. If you got problems, they're not worth it. One of the things that I don't like to ever hear is that this burning talk of the sister and all of that, because those are the ones who ultimately will be there for you when you find yourself in problems. He sounds like one of the voices who would step in when there's a problem. The key of legacy is learn the strength that the person showed you. That's the key of legacy. Okay, don't take it lightly. Don't leave here. You know, all you got one another phone numbers. You can make contact with each other, get each other phone number. Everybody here got phones and call each other, because after today is then the morning really begins. Yeah. Now we're going to go to open tributes.
Denston.
Is here? Yeah. Oh, Denston. Come, man. We're drinking the Roberts and his wife.
We're gonna see the record, Yeah. As I was growing up, I remember Rocky always let me get us our shoes to go back to school. Yeah, clocks.
Yeah,
never forget them.
Yeah.
So Rocky always did it for me, but I was growing up. All right, let's do this. I write a song too far, right? So, what they ask me to do is sing, I don't think. I'm going to sing one, but I'm going to sing this one verse. God gives life, and he takes away. He is the water, and I claim. When I view the last sunset and cross over the sea, I know the sunrise will be waiting for me. Let me see. One more time.
Yeah.
Oh, a sunrise is going to be. Death will lose its sting and a great victory. Sing along the silence.
You would make Sanchez get worried, boy.
Welcome, everybody. Welcome, everybody.
We have tributes.
The tribute.
Yes, and you know, I have so much to say, but I guess.
Go ahead and say. They
can say. Oh, yeah? Okay. You know, why we are here this evening? Because of two people. You know those two people, right? Those two people, why we are here this evening. When God created this world, He created perfect beings. And He tell them, don't do this or don't do that. They had a choice. They disobeyed. And from that, tears, pain, sickness, sorrow, death, you name it. All this thing you can think of. That's why we're here this evening. And it's hard to rule up onto the grave. But this song says, I know you have the strength that Jesus gave. We are gathered here because we love the Thompson family. I don't know many of them, but Louise, a lady with a heart of gold. You see how beautiful she is? She's more beautiful inside. But don't matter how come with me. But I know that no matter who we are, wherever we are, when we lose loved ones, we need the support of friends and relatives. Okay. Some of us have left or maybe dropped earlier, so we can come and support Louise and our family this evening. And a lot of people are sort of paranoid now because of the pandemic, but thank God, I'm sure we who are here this evening don't forget about coronavirus. God is our healer, is our protector. So the show goes on. And I just want to share this. It's a song. We all know it, many people know it. But one of the verses, when death has come and taken our loved ones, it leaves our hearts so lonely and drear. Then do we wonder why others prosper, living so wicked year after year? You know, when you put people in there,
yeah.
I just thought it wicked, like, yeah. Right?
Yeah.
They do so much evil. Yeah. They're not trying to get corona. But you know what? We serve a God, and so when the wicked prosper now, that they're going to be destroyed further. I'm not sure of this.
Rocky.
What's his relation to God with God? But God is just and He's merciful. Even He only brought that very last minute.
Yeah.
God told him,
yeah.
Today, I say unto you, you're going to be with me in paradise.
Yes.
So let us hope and pray,
yeah,
that Rocky made it right with God.
Yeah.
And you know what? So good. I'm not taking over from here to show that it's your right. End of saying this, listen, people, just watch the news. It breaks your heart for what is going on. The inhumanity, the crime. When a mother can take a swim and bash them in the head and kill them 6 weeks old. And a father, two different ones within 3 months. Like, oh God, we talk about Black Lives Matter, don't even get started. But you know what? We know that we have a God and He's just and He's good. And one day He's going to put and all this and suffering. As the program continues, we're going to ask Serena. Serena, is she the youngest child?
Yes.
When I saw the video of that little girl, it broke my heart. And she's so dear. And so my daddy, she's feeling so he would come to her and he would make her tea and all that. It broke my heart. I didn't know her, but when I saw that video, believe me, people. Just came to my eyes. But you know, my dear child, you have a very loving family, and God is gonna help you through all the days you don't have your dad because you are your father. You learn to pray, and God will give you such a joy in your heart that will be missing them. All right?
Okay.
You know? She feels shy. She understands.
Is it clear that Daddy loves
you? You can do it. We are up here and you're down here. What if you think it is?
Yes.
Come up here. So.
all of your aunties, all the people are down here, your aunties. Are you our auntie?
Yes.
Are you our uncle?
Yes.
And you're about family. Do we have prayer? Come. You want to wait a little bit?
Yeah.
We understand, baby girl. Yeah. I grew up in the church, and I remember on Sabbath, we go to the synagogue and we start in the red curtain Sabbath, and we go up and say, reverse fencing. As it comes to my friend, so I know what you're going through. The brave old time, but when you look down and see all those guys looking back at you, forget about it. Okay, where's Danny?
Danny?
Okay, come to Danny. Let's hear what you have.
I'm going to dedicate this song to my dad, the father, my lover, and my friend. Thank you. Even you see, don't go. It will hold you in that way. Mere sweet memories that is all I'm taking with me. In every step of the way.
God is the same.
And the things that will be you standing there. God is the only one who gives peace. No matter how they live, no matter how different they are, we don't have Jesus, we don't have anything. So let us make our calling and election sure. Here we have, when the roll is called up yonder,
this is just higher than God wants to do.
Okay. Oh, is contributed?
Yes.
Okay. Is there coming up?
Two more
today. Okay. And it's going to be 3 minutes?
2 minutes.
2 minutes. Okay, we cut it down. Our time flies. All right. Make it short and sweet, man.
I will try. Good afternoon. Family and friends, and family, Uncle Dan, Andrew, and Rocky.
Welcome to the Big Apple.
Thank you. If I didn't make it here, I don't know how I would do. The song that instant sang, I sang that song 1 week before afternoon. The all that is said about Rocky earlier on, everything is true. If I would begin to say anything, I would be just reinforcing what was said. My brother was a kind person. When he welcomed you with a happy vibe, no matter how you feel coming from where you're coming from, when you welcome me, you get a warm, wonderful welcome. I don't think what I have to say about Rocky, I didn't say when looking forward to going back to school in September, you look forward for his shoes. I would have, when I get his shoes, and I make sure you get it before early time. I used to tell my mom I want the one with the buckle across and the little hole at the top. And I love to smell the lemon. You always make sure we get our shoes. I heard somebody talk about him welcoming, taking care of pregnant sister. I was one of them. I was having difficulty in my relationship. I want to leave back on Sunday. I've got a church to go to Rocky. And I obey that pastor. And when I reached to the gate, and he saw me, he stand up, he said, my sister, and he laughed, he said, come in, come in. And I walked him, and he hugged me, and I cried, and I tell him what take place, and he says to me, and he took care of me like I was his baby mother. I helped him to strip tambourine, and he liked my pride of me. And I remember growing up, he used to play my daddy words at times. Sometimes my father would be far away. He made sure he came early to milk the cows so we could get milk to go to school. He was a family person. And we say reason for the season and season for the reason. God knows why. When God ready to reap, he would reap the best of his harvest. So rest in peace, my brother. Rest in peace.
Anybody want to say something? Anybody hearing me want to say something? Put your hand up right there. Polly, where are you? Want to say something? Who is this? Anyone want to say something?
Yes, they try.
Asha? Polly,
did you need to get on?
Go ahead again, repeat.
Turn it around.
Granddad, he wouldn't like it. I guess I gotta call him uncle. was our female. And he got mad at me. You know, look at your color, girl. Well, no girl in the room anymore. That's right. I have so much other men this week. There's never a day where I got worried about what to eat. I always make sure there was food provided. But I admit, I do like this food better than my mom cooks.
But just think about the happy times, the good times, and treasure them in your heart. And the road is full of water. Inviting everybody to stand. And now we are going to have the prayer of comfort.
You already had that.
You have it already?
Yes, I did that in the space so that we work.
Okay. So now we stand for the offertory, offering time?
No, this time. This is the offertory here.
You are singing blessings.
Okay. When I think about offertory, it's called the offertory. Sorry. Blessed are the poor and Jesus Christ.
Blessed is the Lord, Jesus is my Lord. Oh, what a fortress of glory mine, who gave up salvation, purchased all.
sailing, washed in His blood. Hallelujah, hallelujah, Lord. This is my story. This is my song. I pray to my Savior.
There all the time. We can talk to Him anywhere, on our knees or walking on the street. There's no business line. You can always get through to Him. And you know what? When you talk to Him, the fact that He made 7 billion people on earth, He looks down on you like you are the only one. You know, Jesus wants to have life. He said, I have come that He might have life. And I have come on that. God created in one man to die, but He had a plan. Plan of redemption. He sent Jesus. Jesus took the sins of the world on Himself. And He died on the cross so we can have eternal life. I pray as we sit and listen to Bishop Clark that we will meditate on what He will say to us this evening. And for one that is walking the Lord. May rock His life, help you to understand that life is uncertain. We do not know what tomorrow brings. The other word in the Bible says, here today, gone tomorrow. But believe in people, here today, gone today. So many people have left their homes. They never go back. They go out and they come later. They never make it back home. So let us live each day, like this last day, as we give our hearts to God.
Thank you. You've actually introduced my sermon for me, which is good. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Don't worry, it wouldn't be long, but I'll be very to the point. I usually give a warning before I preach. I'm not politically correct. I preach only what the Word of God says. If you have a problem with it, don't take it out on me. Talk to the Lord about it. Because I'm seeing what He wants me to see. I like to remind people that I cannot, if you're working at Burger King, you can't sell McDonald's food. They're going to fire you. If I'm a minister of the Lord, I can't give you the devil's words. So all I can promise you is the truth. Now, I first want to start by letting you understand there is something that a word that has been used constantly here today. And that's the word love. Very few people, including Christians, really understand how much God loves you. Very few could get it. Because God's love is not like ours. There's a part of the scripture that says God is love. A few scriptures that tells us about God's love. The most popular one, John 3:16, for God so loved the world. But He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in Him will not perish, but will have everlasting or eternal life. The Bible also says that God wished that none would be lost. We have to understand that when you're called, for example, to surrender your life to the Lord, it's an opportunity that only God could give. Remember, you mentioned it earlier. God started the human race on earth with two people. They messed up. God could have decided then, that's it, I ain't dealing with human beings anymore, squash them. But He loved them so much that He decided to make a way to bring them and their generations back in line with him. But it says that Christ was the lamb slain before the foundation of the earth.
Yes.
That is before God created the world, he already knew that we were going to sin.
Oh, yes.
But he loved us so much that he decided that he's going to make a way and he'll allow you to make the choice. Because the Bible says, choose you this being whom you will serve. Let me tell you something about this God that loves you. When you go through the scripture, there's a particular set of scripture that I love to use. David must have heard it over and over and over again. Because I find that it's the one piece of scripture that tells you who this Jesus that you talk about really is. People use Jesus' name something like a curse word, not understanding that they're talking about the very God. And that's the one that loves you so much that the Bible says, like I told you just now, that Christ was the lamb slain before the foundation of the earth. Imagine before he made man, because he knows all things, he knew that man was going to sin, yet he loved man enough to leave his glory and put on flesh, come and be birthed in this stuff that he made of dust. Knowing what we were going to do with him, he was going to be spat upon, he was going to be beaten, he was going to be ultimately killed. And yet, he chose to do it. All because of his love for us. You know, imagine the size of the universe. Man doesn't know the size of the universe. Because we keep discovering and discovering and discovering the heavens. We keep discovering more and more. These things are light years away. Those that are nearby, look how many years it takes us to send something to go and land there. And those that are nearby, within our sphere, they go and they find that. But the Bible tells us something about Jesus. And I'm going to read it. Because it's the one book in the Bible where there's a conversation between the Father and the Son. And many times when I ask people this question, they don't know. Even when I ask pastors, I'm a director for a seminary. I make pastors. And you ask them in the early stages when they're not going to do the associates or the bachelors or what have you. Do you know where in the Bible there's a conversation between the Father and the Son? No, Dr. Clark, I've never seen any part. And sometimes these are people who are already preaching. These are people who run in congregations. I have also discovered that we have a lot of people who have some of their biggest churches. But they didn't know the Bible says that you must study the word of God to show yourself approved unto God. So that you'll be a workman who could rightly divide the word of truth. Today we have so much misinformation. So much disinformation. We've got so many doctrines that have come into the world today that has nothing to do with truth. Nothing to do with it. So today what we want is some truth. Let's first see who Jesus really is. The book of Hebrews says, God who at sundry times in diverse manner spake in time past unto the fathers by the prophets, hath in these last days spoken unto us by his Son, whom he had appointed heir of all things, by whom also he made the worlds. So the first thing we're setting on here is that within the Godhead, Christ is the creating one. Who be the brightness of his glory, the express image of his person, and upholding all things by the word of his power, when he had by himself purged our sins, sat down on the right hand of the majesty on high. I mean, when Jesus had already paid for our sins, he went back to his glory. being made so much better than the angels, and yet by inheritance obtained the more excellent name from thee. For all the which of the angels, now this part of the conversation now shows you, they ask you, when did the Father ever do these things? And you will see it later. For all the which of the angels said, he attained that, thou art my son, this day have I begotten thee. And again, I will be to him a father, and he will be to me a son. He never said so to any angel. Never called any of his angels his begotten. And again, when he had brought in the first begotten into the world, he said, and let all the angels of God worship him. Even when Christ came on earth and walked as man, he was worshipped by his angels because he was the God-man. In the Old Testament, the prophet called him Emmanuel, meaning God with us. It's usually nice when I'm preaching and you have Christians who could help me along, who know that I'm talking the truth. And of the angels, he said, who maketh his angels spirits and his ministers a flame of fire? But unto the Son he said, thy throne, O God, the Father is calling the Son God. Is forever and ever a scepter of righteousness is the scepter of thy kingdom. Thou hast loved righteousness and hated iniquity. Therefore, God, even thy God hath anointed thee with oil of gladness above thy petals. He said, therefore, God, even thy God, they are God to each other. So the Father calls the Son God, and the Son calls the Father God. How dare us talk about the man of God? He's God. Because you need to understand that this is the God who loves you so much that put on flesh and came into this world to die for each one of us in here. There isn't a little soul that God has ever made that God doesn't love. Because the word of God says that God wishes that none will be lost. None will be lost. He said, and thou, Lord, the Father now addressing the Son as the Lord. In the beginning has laid the foundation of the earth, and the heavens are the works of thy hands. That's Jesus. That's the Jesus that loves us. That made the heavens and the earth, and man out of dust. The Bible said that he formed the dust of the earth together, put it in the shape, and he breathed into man, and man became a living soul. And then we turned around and we disobeyed him and we followed the devil, we obeyed the devil. And yet, God still loves us. He loves us to the point of where he came and he died for our sins. Imagine we sin against God, and his love is so much that he decided to pay for our sins. It's like if your child do something wrong that is deserving of punishment, then we decide to get a whip and spank ourselves. That would never happen. But that's the love that God has for us. And the same God says, then you must make your calling and election sure. The Bible says, if you confess your sins and believe in your heart that Jesus Christ is Lord, you will be saved. Look how easy God made this thing for us. Imagine he came and paid for the sins of the world. All of us, he has already paid the sins for. And all we have to do is to accept that we're sinners. And confess to him, Lord, I have sinned against you. Please forgive me and be my God. It's not complicated like how we try to make it. You know, we end up with all sorts of rituals. You got to burn this candle, you got to do that. No, that doesn't bring salvation. The Bible says, believe in your hearts and confess with your tongue, and thou shalt be saved. And we're the ones who add all these fancy stuff to the thing to make it complicated. Do we get to the point to where you can't even go directly to God, some minister God to God your behalf? No! When you become a child of God, you have the same access to God that I have. God does not love me more than any of you here. Understand it. There's nothing better about me than any of you. I don't care what you look like. I don't care what you share. I don't care what kind of sickness you've got. I don't care what you look like when you were born. God's love for you is equal. For God so loved the world. I'm going to close off shortly. Let me just tell you on something that I think I should really do.
Say,
Let me tell you why I come to all this important. Remember, I told you how many funerals I've already done? This is 188 in the past month, past year, and 1 month. One day, the morning I got up as usual, I usually get up between 4 and 4:30 to pray. Because I have a lot of responsibilities, a lot of pastoral responsibilities. I got a lot of ministers out there, I got 15 bishops out there. I have a lot of responsibilities. But one thing I promised myself is that I will live like everybody else. I don't need no heirs and stuck up. No! I'm a servant. I am a servant of God. The servant can never be greater than the master. The Bible says so. I am not better than anybody else that God uses. We all got our own roles to play. So not because somebody happened to be a bishop and all that. Those are functionary positions that God has called some of us to. Because some were sent and some went. And one morning I got up and I was praying and I told him, I said, Father, Lord Jesus, the last thing, one of the last instructions you gave us before you ascended back to your glory was that we must go into all the world and preach the gospel. You see, we must go on the highways and byways and preach the gospel. And some of us get comfortable sitting in the rooms with our congregants. And we meet there on Sunday and we preach the word of God and we meet there during the week if we got Bible study and prayer meeting or what. But it's all to the same group of people. And the chances are that most of the people in that congregation already know you. That's why they're there. But what about those outside that haven't heard your word? That's why you say, go and preach. Even when Jesus rose, what did he tell Mary? He said, go and tell. Father, the people who go to church already know something about you. The people who look at Christian television know something about you. People who go on Christian radio know something about you. But the bulk of the world doesn't know you. And your instructions, you left that responsibility to us. I said, so Lord, I need you to put me in a position where I could reach those unreached. Those are the ones I want to meet. To reach the unreached because they need to know. They don't know. They're doing things in their life that doesn't please you, but many times they don't know. Because the Bible says, how can they know unless there's a preacher? Unless someone tells them. I'm fortunate that I have been told and, you know, raised in a home where 3 of us are pastors and, you know. But that's how you bless me. I want you to bless everybody the same way. I need to be able to reach those people. And then shortly after the funeral, called me and one of the owners, and he said, Bishop, why do so many people request you to do the funeral services? I said, I don't know. I can't answer that question. Then he called me back a few days later and said, I know why. He said, because the lady was here this morning and she wanted to do a funeral. And I asked her when she asked if she could get Bishop Black at the funeral, Bishop Black. She said, but I don't really know him, but I was at the funeral service he did a few weeks ago. And he stood there and spoke the truth, and only the truth, and that's what I want my loved ones to hear. And he told them that heaven is open for all of us, just by one way, through one person. And then he told me, he said, oh, listen, could we ask you to be our con minister when we have services, could we come when we do our work? I said, of course. And I went home rejoicing. Because God had answered my prayer. Let me tell you how God had answered that prayer. The only place that people will gather in these numbers that didn't willfully go to hear about God is at a funeral service.
Yes.
When you go to a funeral service, you go there to console your loved ones and you know that, but you don't really realize you're going to church. So, Father, do me one favor. Those that you're calling, send them anytime I am preaching. So my, as far as I'm concerned, every one of you in here, whether you know it or not, he has called you to be here, either to remind you or to strengthen you or to let you know that he loves you and he is calling on you and he expects that you will respond. So you're not here by accident. It's a further blessing that came from his passing. So even in his death,
amen. Amen.
God has called. So just remember, the price for your salvation has already been paid.
Oh, yeah.
All you gotta do is pick it up. All you gotta do is make that choice. Whenever you make one choice, you have made more than one choice at the same time. So don't tell me, well, why would God send people to hell? A lot of people ask, why would God send people to hell? Say, God, the Bible says that God wished that none would be lost. And then he said, if you must choose where you want to go. But if you don't choose him, he's not going to force you to be with him in the next life. You see, everybody in here is sitting right now. Except the lady in the camera and myself. We made a choice to sin. In making that choice, we also made the choice not to stand. So when you make a choice to not choose Christ, it means you've made a choice not to be with him. Don't make that mistake. God loves you more than you can imagine. At least try Jesus. Try him. Don't start off with, well, God, you ain't got nothing. All have sinned and come short of the glory of God. All of us were born in sin and shaped in iniquity. So please, I give you Jesus.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
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 Praise God for his words. We have a witness here.
Amen.
Word of God in life. And he says, again, I have come that you might have life, that you might have the fruit. Relatives, friends, you heard the message. God will your decision be. Jesus was speaking to her that there's crucifixion. He said in verse 5, and before that he told them, they have to have each other. And they're going to be afraid. I am going to prepare a place for you. If I want to prepare a place for you, I will come again. And God's words are to be promises are to you and they are faithful. And we know that one day, all the sinners of the you know, I think it's in James to say, I have not seen, neither have he heard, nor has it entered to the hearts of man, but God has gone to prepare for his will. Don't make a thing to me. God has done his part. Jesus came. He suffered. He was humiliated. He was slaughtered. He never came to him about the same thing he made. He didn't ever say about them. Then he made the devil. You know? So we have a choice. God wants us to be saved and he can put him and he can go to the cross so he can have eternal life. Family and friends, I just want to extend gratitude on behalf of the Francis family for coming out this evening to support them. Family, friends, relatives,
Now the song says, blessed be the tie that binds your hearts and the spirit of God. The fellowship of kindred minds is like that above. We will be leaving here and we'll be going home, but they will still be grieving. Let's remember them in our bereavement. When we pray, let's pray for them. That precious little girl came up. Then know the thing that I love my daddy. She can say, I miss my daddy. That you cannot love her anymore, but she can hold love in her heart for as long as she lives. In our father's life, was cut short. He was supposed to live longer. You know, I can't wrap my mind about the menopause, 969 years. Then it cut down to 9, then to 8, to 7, 120. Then David said, the years of a man, life is 3, 4, and 10. That's 70. He didn't make 70, but God knows why. God has a plan. And I'm sure because of mistake, somebody here may have a new experience with God. So let us take this life as we live for the moment and this future. What a vibrant man, stylish, you know, just posing and all that. That was one of the most human I think. Well, right now, we cannot see what we're seeing, what we hear. Don't wait until a person is there to say the right things, right? It's not them, but tell them how much they need. We should do it now. Now, we can give the roses right now. Don't wait till Mother Day, some kind of stroke. Here, you know, say a good word, send a card, send a tip, because life is short. I just want to thank our Zoom lady here. She's having a good job. All those who are watching on Zoom, thank you for being here. We appreciate it. And I'm using my hand clapping and sampling. That's the heart of any service. Music, praise. I want to thank you so much on behalf of the family. So, what I hope she can give you pictures. She's not listening. Thank you so much, videographer, for being here this evening and just making memories so they can have it to look back on for a long time. We thank you. And on behalf of the council, we really appreciate it. Pastor, Bishop, Evangelist, all those words, you know, we appreciate coming here and just being a part of the service for the life of Rocky. And I'm sure Rob also agreed. We thank you. And we pray that we continue to live well. And to tell men and women of the wonderful God. Those some go before us, we'll all meet again, just inside that holy city as we enter in. There be no more parting, for with Jesus we'll be together forever, God's family. Let us keep holding on to the Lord. Trust His love, believe His word, for support with your hearts and mind, and make that coming, that day, when you shall burn the soul of heaven, and the capacity to survive, that waiting for Him and to receive us. Friends, family members, keep holding on. You know, just respect. I know the table is over. This is time heals, you know, it may be true. I lost my parents 1 year apart, and even on birthdays come on, but there's something I'm just talking about. You know, I'm not just talking about it. So, all I have to remember is cry when you want to cry. Okay? Don't hold it in. Let emotions out. A lot of mixed emotions, but when we release them, we feel so much better. Welcome to the time when we are going to part. But as I said, one day there will be no more party. No more. God wants us to live forever. So we have to live now so we can live that forever. No more sins. No more dying. No more mass shooting. No more pandemic. Because all these will be passing away. May God bless you. May you join safe. There's a repass for those who want to join. It's right under the building. And before we do that, we are going to have the benediction. Bishop Clark. I hope I don't go to anybody. Tom, can you hear everybody?
Yeah. Can you stand and receive the anointing, please? Benediction. May the Lord bless and keep you. May the Lord cause his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you and give you his peace. Amen. 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 God bless you.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, I know. Thank you. Okay, come on, let's go.